I can't take you guys, but I can actually show you one of my projects that I've done in this one. So I'll be right back.
Guys, back away from the door.
Yeah, go ahead and look over that. Go over, look over that, it's pretty cool. Oh, he's got this too. You gonna bring it out here, Michael?
Yeah.
Okay.
So, this was for a competition called the AICHE Chemi Car Competition.
Boys?
And the goal of that competition was to make a small car that's capable of moving a certain distance, and it has to be powered by chemical reactions, and it has to stop by chemical reactions as well. So they give us the time, like the amount of distance it needs to go, like an hour before the competition, and then we have to modify the chemical reaction inside the car to go how long we need it to go to travel as close to that mark as possible. And that's kind of how it's scored. So we went for a car that was powered by a heat difference. So these ceramic cells in between here, they are called Peltier cells, and they're capable of creating electricity based on temperature differences. So in this chamber of the car, we had a component of cement, calcium oxide, and when you mix that with water, it gets really hot, like boiling hot. And then in this part, we had dry ice and acetone, and we chose acetone because water will freeze around dry ice, but acetone has a way lower freezing point. So that heat difference provided enough electricity to allow the car to move. And then the stopping mechanism, which was this, was an iodine clock. And iodine clock reactions, when you start them, depending on the concentration of iodine in the mixture, it will, like, it's a clear solution, and then it will suddenly turn completely black, like at a really specific time. So we just vary the amount of the concentration of iodine in that clock to change how long the car goes. And then here you can kind of see some of the electronics that we use for controlling the motors on the bottom of the car. That actually made it run.
Question?
Why is
there
water
on there?
They also, the competition also varies the amount of weight that the car has to hold as it moves. So then you can measure that in water. So basically the competition will tell you how much weight you're going to put in, and then you have to put it in the car, and that's also confirmed by the competition. That would take a long time because I have to mix up all the reactions. And I didn't have time for that.
Really, what happened to all the other stuff?
What other stuff?
The things that power that.
Oh, they're here. They're all here. I just need to mix up the reactions, and I'm not going to do that.
Does it steer, or does it only go straight?
It only
what
goes
does
straight.
That do?
It only needs to go straight. We could actually program it to steer, but we don't need to. Yeah. Any other questions?
And so what is it?